From New York, you're watching the WB 11 Morning News with John Mullen, Sukanya Christian, Emmeline Francis, Larry Hoff, Linda Church, and Jill Nicolini at Air 11.
All right, holiday travel drama could have you saying bah humbug this season, but you can check out your travel turbulence at the door.
Yeah, Craig Chudwise here with some insider information to help you on your way. Craig.
Well, guys, millions of Americans will be crowding airports around the nation as the holiday season gets into full swing, but there are little things you can do now to ensure smooth sailing all around. Travelers across the country are gearing up for another hectic holiday season. But your great escape doesn't have to be a hassle if you know the tricks of the trade.
I think the most important thing you can do is to book a nonstop flight this time of year. You know, when your chances of encountering a delay or cancellation double if you take a one-stop flight. If you do have to take a one-stop flight, try to book your flight through a hub that's not delay-plagued, like Atlanta or Dallas or Houston.
Your departure time could save you money and a lot of delay drama.
Taking the first flight out in the morning is usually a little bit less expensive, or taking the red eye instead of a flight, you know, during the peak times, which are pretty much the, you know, the rush hour peaks, anywhere from about 7 to 10 a.m. or 4 to 8 p.m. at night.
If you've got money on your mind this season, one-stop shopping could save you a bundle.
It always pays off to book a package deal where you combine your air, your hotel, and car rental all at once. Travelers save about $200 on average when you book package deals. And, you know, the good thing about this is it's a one-stop shop. You get everything in one place and you're not jumping all around the internet.
And just because you're visiting family doesn't mean you all have to stay under the same roof.
Big downtown hotels that typically cater to business travelers are empty during the holidays, and they really discount their rooms 40, 50, or 60%.
When it comes to gift giving,
I think this year is the year to just say no to traveling with gifts. You know, you want to get through the airport as quickly as possible. If you're laden down with a bunch of gifts that are going to be opened at security, it's just going to slow you down. Give gift certificates this year. Do some shopping at your destination. You know, that way it's just going to make your trip a lot easier.
And for more inside tips on holiday travel, you can check out our website at cw11.com/morningnews.
All right.
Thank you. Craig, thanks.